son of missionaries, Philip Johnston moved to Flagstaff, Arizona, on a Navajo reservation. After playing and interacting with the children, he was fluent in the Navajo language by the age of 5.
I'm just playing with you.
He was able to translate for his father to get land for him to build his mission.
Chindi didn't know you.
Oh, he says okay.
By the age of 9, Johnston went to Washington, D.C., where he served as an interpreter for the Navajos when they lobbied for Native American rights.
I'm going to enlist in World War I.
Off to France. There he saw Comanche code talkers.
What's he doing?
Code talking.
The U.S. military needed new codes for World War II. They needed codes that were hard to break because important messages about tactics were sent. Currently, codes took hours to encrypt and decrypt.
Oh, what a great idea! Yippee, hooray!
General, I have a great idea for what we should do for World War II code problem.
Tell me about it!
Well, you see, the Navajo language is ideal, because less than 30 non-natives can actually speak the language, and none of these people are Japanese. I have demonstrated using 4 Navajos the potential success of this. It took these men only 20 seconds to decode a 3-line message, something it would take a machine half an hour to do.
By Jove, I'll drink to that.
The Navajo experience in war was a very unique one. The original 29 men who were first decided to be both educated enough in English and Navajo wrote the entire code. Before they could do this, they had to go to boot camp.
5,000, oh, go, do 4 laps, go, go. The code you have come up with must be entirely memorized, because there are not many war-related words in the Navajo language. Words that used to mean swallow now mean torpedo plane.
Because of strict regulations, some of the men did not continue on.
Navajo Indians were used as code talkers during World War II. They helped the U.S. Marines during every assault in the Pacific after they were trained from 1942 until 1945. This included Guadalcanal, Parawa, and more importantly, Iwo Jima. During the first 48 hours there, 6 Navajo radio workers worked around the clock and translated over 800 messages perfectly. Some men were greeted as heroes when they returned. The Navajos, however, did face many problems when they returned. Used to the equality that they had in the Marines, they were disappointed in how they were treated in society. Many of them tried to assimilate by moving to the city, but realized they were not treated equally. Also, many soldiers who came back were either shunned by their family or were forced to go under a purifying rite. The average Native American male had an income one-third the size of that of a white male. Because code talkers were also used in the Korean-Vietnam War, what the code talkers in World War II did remained classified until June 28, 1968, when they received formal recognition, a Medal of Honor from the 4th Marine Division.